Crap with Beth and Matt. Cut to Crap is the world's number one no bullshit health and fitness podcast.
Beth!
Matt!
What is going on?
What the fuck isn't?
I hear you. It's been a whirlwind of a couple weeks, hasn't it?
Yeah. Yes, it has. How many trips have you been on this past?
Well, let's see. So I had my hiking trip in Tennessee in Gatlinburg, in Pigeon Forge, at the Great Smoky Mountains. And then I was in Pittsburgh visiting my buddy. And then I'm getting ready to go out of town again. I'm going to Alaska next week.
Amazing. Wow. That's awesome.
Yeah. And yourself?
Well, I hiked Mount Katahdin, which was super intense.
How'd that go?
10 hours. It's 10 miles and 10 hours. So 5.2 up and 5.2 down. But
Don't you hate that hike back down?
I do. And it's not even, I wouldn't even call it a hike. It's like bouldering. Hiking in the East Coast or, especially at like New Hampshire, the White Mountains, it's like rocks.
It's like the Appalachian Trail, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Yep. It's the end of the Appalachian Trail. So that's where everyone finishes.
Okay. You don't start there. You end there.
Yeah. I guess you could start. If you start there, then you'd have to go all the way to Georgia. So I guess it's like either way. Yeah.
Either way. Yeah. Yeah. Yep. I feel that the hike that we went on, the long hike that we went on in the Smoky Mountains was very rocky, very just tree roots everywhere, rocks everywhere, and especially like the last mile. But I want to hear more about yours.
Yeah. So it's bouldering. And so it's a couple of spots, literally me and my friend sat down, and I've done this hike probably 8 times, but it is so hard. It's one of those things that every single time you kind of have a little breakdown. So we sat there and there's these metal rungs that I don't even know how they get them into these rocks. So you actually have to hoist yourself up, like climb this metal ladder.
Badass.
One wrong move. And it's like, your fault. You're going to get hurt.
For sure.
We're looking at each other like, she's like, I don't know if I can do this. I'm like, I don't know if I even want to do this. And we both start crying. And I was like, no, we're doing it, Mandy. We've done it before. We can do it again. Let's just go. I'm like, just one foot in front of the other. Just look right in front of you. Don't look side to side. Cause it's, it's by this time, we're probably 3,000 or 4,000 feet up.
That's insane.
It's like 5,200 and something feet to the top. And it's a climb. It's a climb. And especially I was struggling with my anxiety so bad, because the day before I got some blood work done and the doctor called me and was like, you need to retest your blood work. You have a low white blood cell count, and I do not do well with that kind of stuff. I have like massive health anxiety. I struggled with it for like 30 years since my father passed away suddenly. So I'm like obsessed with anything. If I have like a pain, I immediately go to the worst. So she's like, do you have a history of leukemia? I'm like, no. She's like, okay, well, we're gonna have to test in 30 days to make sure everything's all right. So of course, the whole time I'm like planning my fucking funeral. I'm like, Jesus, I'm like, what if I do have leukemia? I know something's not right. And it was just the what ifs
got
to you. It was bad. Yeah. And it still is. Like, I'm struggling hard right now.
Damn it, Beth.
I know. I'm working through it.
Yeah. I know we've been chatting. I mean, we haven't been chatting as much as we have, and we've both been so busy, but I know the feeling of being overwhelmed is very real, right? A lot of anxiety and stress. Yeah. And it's not all bad. It's not, of course, when your health is, when we're talking about your health, of course, that could potentially be bad, but
right.
So how long before you get answers on that?
I take another test like at the end of September. And my mother-in-law is a nurse, and I've talked to a lot of people, but, like, if she was really worried, you'd be testing a lot sooner. And your white blood cells fluctuate all the time, which is something I didn't know. Like, everything else about my blood work was fine.
Yeah.
It was just that.
Got it.
And of course, I feel fine.
Right. So. Yeah. I mean, I'm the eternal optimist. I'm sure everything's fine. It'll be just a bunch of worrying for nothing. Right.
Yeah. Hopefully. That's, yeah.
Of course. That's tough to do though. Yeah.
I'm creating my like own stomach pain. Like I have so much anxiety right now. I've lost like 3 to 4 pounds. I'm having a hard time eating. When I stress, I don't eat. So it's like I'm having to force feed myself smoothies and things just to, you know, get
just
in
get
my
calories and energy in.
Yeah. And that's been a struggle. And also like making myself get outside. I went outside once in the past 6 days. And it's like something we tell our clients. You need to like relieve some stress, get outside, walk.
Yes.
As soon as I took that walk, I felt so much better. And it's like
mental health almost improves right away, right? When we go on those walks, get that fresh air. I'm sure this time of year is probably beautiful there in Maine.
The
weather's probably starting to turn. Here in Ohio, it's chilly in the morning, chilly in the evening, and then still like almost at 90 degrees in the day. But I love those cool mornings on my walks.
Yeah,
it's like you said, like clearly you're not motivated at that time. You know, you'd much rather probably just sit on the couch and wallow in your pity, right?
Fucking Google doctor.
Oh God. Yeah. Get on WebMD and then you're going to die tomorrow. If you start.
I've had probably like 6 diseases in the past week, but that's where I go. That's a problem. That's my problem.
Yeah.
And I'm like
working
trying
through
to
it.
I'm trying to find a therapist. I'm going to cranial sacral therapy right now, which is helping a little bit. But
so hell is cranial psychotherapy? I have no clue what that
is. It's like it works with your nervous system. It's like in the same realm as like Reiki massage, but he just like manipulates, like it's like weird pressure points. There's no needles, but he like goes underneath and it'll press like this, and it like works with the energy of your body. It's a trip, but it like works. You're like he'll start moving his hands down, like your stomach and your back, and you start feeling like your stomach gurgling. It's
weird.
Yeah, it's weird. And he's been asking me some intense questions. It's almost like he's kind of like a therapist. He's, you know, it's like, where does this, you know, fear come from? I want you to like, think about like, as he's like doing this stuff, like, where is this, when did you start feeling like, you know, this fear?
Mm-hmm.
And said all this stuff started coming up. And I was like, oh my God, you know, my husband had a stroke in front of me. My father passed away suddenly. And he's like, okay, so those are all like really tragic things.
Right.
And so, you know, it's this old trauma.
And if we don't deal with that trauma, it rears its ugly head out of nowhere, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's crazy. Well, everything's going to be okay, Beth. Breathe.
It's going to be okay. I know.
Definitely.
Yeah. I've been doing some breath work, you know, that's another meditating.
Yeah, for sure. I've actually on a TikTok live yesterday, I was just sitting on the porch and just started doing some breathing exercises and just kind of talking through it, what I was doing with everybody on live. I was like, come on guys, let's do this. You know,
I love that. Yeah. Cause your body can't be in fight or flight, which was what I was told. Like when you're doing the breath work, it kind of takes you into another, like not the fight or flight.
Right. Yeah. For sure. So then the rest of the hike though, so you conquered it, of course.
Yeah, we did it. And I made a TikTok about it, which was cool.
Okay.
Documented it. I was really sore. Really sore.
Did you stay there that night or did you hike back down that day as well?
We stay there. Well, you can't stay in the mountain. I mean, you have to hike back down. Okay. And then we stayed at a hotel that night. We're like, we're not driving back. It's like a 3-hour drive.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, other than like worrying about your health, were you able to kind of decompress and kind of clear your head in other ways?
Yeah. Oh yeah. It was great. Good. It was ultimately.
So yeah, I don't know if I saw the video that you did, but I went hiking. We did a 8.1 mile hike, which was our long hike that we did when we were down there. Ramsey Cascades Trail, it was called. Mm-hmm. So it was like 4 miles. It was eight miles in and out. Right. So it was 2,200 foot elevation, I believe.
Yeah,
not super intense, but it was the last mile of it was very intense. It was like a 30% incline, very rocky. So we had to do a lot of maneuvering around rocks.
Yeah.
A lot of scooting around on our butt and climbing and things like that. And that took its toll, especially on that way down. Walking back down is so much harder, right?
It is, yeah.
So much harder on your body walking down like that, especially when you're walking on nothing but rocks and tree trunks and things like that. So
it's mentally, like, cause you got to mentally think of like where you're going to step and, you know.
Yeah. Yeah. You constantly got to be on point.
Yeah.
Thankfully we had a nice payoff at the end of the trail, right? We hiked up to a waterfall, 100-foot waterfall, which was freaking phenomenal. We had it to ourselves. There was one other couple there when we got there and they left shortly after us. So we kind of just chilled out for a little bit. And of course I went in and I pulled up my pants and walked through and almost bit it a couple of times because it was so damn slippery, but it was freezing ice cold water coming through those mountains, of course, you know.
Was it hot there?
In the forest, it wasn't. In the mountains, it wasn't. When you're down at the, you know, at sea level or wherever the hell it is, it was like 90 degrees on those days. But in the forest, in the mountains, it was like 70 degrees.
So, nice.
Yeah, it was very cool. Yeah.
Awesome. I love the wilderness.
Same. Yeah. I mean, that's my thing, actually. I go hiking. I love to go hiking. And for me, like, I usually go hiking on my own, just around here, or I'll travel on my own and go do it. And that's just my way of getting away. And that's kind of how I have my, like, self-care, right? And that's what I do for myself, just to get away and refocus and come back re-energized and refocused. Mm-hmm. So,
do you have a lot of trails near you?
Yes, but I mean, it's very flat here in Ohio, at least where I'm at in Ohio, Northwest Ohio. So we have long trails, but they're not difficult trails. You know, I can walk all day. I can walk 15 miles in a day if I have to, 20 miles. If it, like in Ohio when it's flat, but when we start getting in the mountains and things like that, of course it gets a lot harder.
Yeah.
If we go out to the east part of Ohio towards like Cleveland, Cuyahoga Valley and things like that, we have a national park out there, National Forest, which has a lot of good hiking trails, and there's some good elevations out there.
Yeah. That's exciting. You're having going to Alaska. It's like my bucket list.
Going to Alaska. We're leaving Sunday on the 12th. We'll be back home on the 20th. My brother's going with me, my sister-in-law. And then, so my friend, Brittany organizes like these group trips for people. And so this is one of the trips that she's doing. We're tagging along. She does all the planning and everything. So I literally just have to pay her and show up and I'm good to go.
Awesome. Which
that's nice for me. I don't have to do any of the planning. I just have to do what I'm, you know, show up. We're going to do lots of hiking. We're going to go to Denali National Park and Kenai Fjords, I think it's called. Uh-huh. And then we're going to do some whale watching, hike on some glaciers, which is going to be really fucking cool.
Yeah. So, really excited.
This is an expensive trip though, damn it. Like buying all this hiking gear that I didn't have, like I had to buy spikes for my boots, my hiking boots, you know, because I didn't have any. And just multiple layers, of course, because this time of year in Alaska, it could be 30 degrees or it could be 70 degrees. And you could get both of those in one day, you know?
Yeah.
So dress in layers and layer off if we have to.
But nice.
Oh,
that's going to be amazing. Prepared. I can't wait to see pictures and videos and all that stuff.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. I'm kind of starting to I want to start doing more like lifestyle content on mm-hmm. my social medias, like just my day-to-day shit that I'm doing. You posted a video of your hike and so did I of my hike in Tennessee. I just want to start doing more stuff.
Yeah, definitely. I think it's important.
Yeah. And it's a nice change of pace for us too, right? Like it gets exhausting talking about the same things every day. So I've really been trying to branch out in my content and like, I'm like, of course I care. Like I talk about a lot about mindset, especially with our clients. Yeah. I know you do as well. So I'm really starting to start talking about more of that stuff. And that's not directly fat loss related, but it does have an impact, you know.
Oh yeah.
Those are the indirect things if, you know, so, and we're not only here for fat loss anyway. So.
Right. Yeah, I agree. I've been talking about mental health a lot. I didn't know it was Suicide Awareness Month. So that's, you know.
Yeah.
Mental health is huge. It's another important thing I noticed, like just in the health industry as well, just to do with, you know, nutrition and fat loss. And I mean, it's all related.
Yeah. Without a healthy body, a healthy mind, your physical health is more than likely going to be suffering. Health is all encompassing. I always say this all the time, physical, mental, emotional, spiritual, if that's your thing, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know. So speaking, not necessarily on the mental health topic, but I created a video last night, somebody left a comment that really just hit me in my feels. And this is a good thing. But I made a video and I didn't even think twice about releasing it. So it's on TikTok. I was actually in tears. I was crying, happy tears.
Yeah.
But somebody left a comment like you literally saved my life is what they said to me.
Oh my God.
And I just fucking lost it. And I'm bawling essentially in this video. But really what's happening there is like, it's nice to see those things, especially because as much bullshit as we receive, you and I receive and other coaches too, it's such a toxic place to be. And that takes its toll and that beats us down, I think.
Yeah.
And so receiving a comment like that from a complete stranger, you know, they're always watching, even if we've never interacted with them, you know, we're impacting them. And it's like, wow. You know,
we forget that too, you know? Mm-hmm. And I don't know about you, but when you talk to, you know, have your sales calls, it's like when it really hits you, you know, when they start telling you their story and they get really emotional and, you know, they remember everything that we've talked about. And it's like, oh my God, I've been following everything that you said and it's made such a difference. And it really is like, wow, like what we're doing is really important. And
100%. Yeah. And you can't say that enough. And not to pump ourselves up, of course, but it is. And because there's so much, and I said that in my video, like, you know, there's so much bullshit out there. Hence you and I, you know, no bullshit coaches, cut the crap.
Yeah.
It's necessary. Because people are out there purposely deceiving people. Mm-hmm. To profit, or to make themselves to further their agenda and line their pockets and things like that.
Right.
And, yes, we're coaches. People pay us for our services, but that's not, you know, why we're in it, you know?
Yeah. And it's just to think like how much they see that they believe that's not true. I was just talking to my mindset coach about this last night and she's like, we know what is true and what is not. But imagine getting bombarded constantly with like, oh my God, should I have those premier protein shakes? Are those really bad? You know, like we know they're not, but other people really will believe that stuff. And that sucks. It's like to have that much information overload and not knowing what to do. Yeah.
Yeah. We're constantly on, you know, as consumers, everything we're constantly being sold. And the most convincing or the most attractive person usually makes the sale, you know, the person that makes the most convincing arguments or is the most polarizing, right? When we see these people that are saying premier protein shakes are bad or whatever's bad fruit or what the fuck ever, they're very polarizing. They very matter of factly, you know, this is bad. And you almost have to believe them because they are speaking like an expert and they're positioning themselves as an expert.
Yeah. It's almost like if you say it to be true, you almost believe it yourself.
Yeah. And what I like to do, and I know exactly like who we're talking about here, but like when we see those things, like, first of all, question everything you see, right?
Yeah.
That's what I tell people, question everything and just do a little trick. Like go to their profile. What are they fucking selling? You know, are they selling a competing supplement? Are they selling a completing magical fat loss pill? Imagine that, you know, I wonder why they would say something so fucking stupid, you know? Now we're getting fired up.
Fuck yeah, let's go. All right.
And it's, you know, like I said, question everything. Most people have a financial incentive for doing what they're doing.
Yeah.
And
it's fucking sad.
Yeah.
It is.
100%.
To play off people's like emotions and vulnerability sucks.
There's a lot of narcissists out there. Snake oil salesmen, that's not a new thing. You know, that's been going on for fucking probably since the beginning of time. But it's unfortunate, you know. When there's money to be made, there's going to be people taking advantage of people flat out. Yeah. So I don't know. What I guess other than like questioning everything that you see, what should people be looking out for? Like when people are taking, like looking for guidance, looking for advice, what are some warning signs that you can think of?
Good question. I think to me, a warning sign is like, this is bad. This is good.
Yeah.
Or, you know, or like, or this is the moral only, value. This is the only thing that works for,
or this is the best.
Yes. Yes. This is the best product out there. You know, always someone saying that, like, this worked for me and it's going to work for everybody.
Oh, that's a good one. This worked for me, right? So anecdotal evidence.
Yeah.
You know? Well, I cut out carbs and I lost 20 pounds. So therefore, carbs made me fat, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or, you know, like a lot of people that don't have an education in nutrition are like, I lost 100 pounds and this is what you need to do.
Yeah. Which we see fucking all the time.
Oh, right? Fuck, man.
And those are the people with 2 million followers.
Yeah.
Further perpetuating all these bullshit myths.
Right. Like the OMAD, or like, I did this in 4 months and lost 100 pounds and you can too. It's like, holy shit.
OMAD. If we would have had this call last week, I was full on ready to just fucking shred intermittent fasting a new one last week. And really? Maybe we still do, you know, but, you know, that coach, of course, that you and I, that everybody was kind of up in arms about, but he's been doing it for so long now.
Right.
Literally telling people, like, intermittent fast, cool. I don't give a fuck if that's what you do, you know,
truly.
If that works for you, great. But don't be bullshitting people. Like, you're telling people to eat a small protein meal with veggies for lunch and then a snack at 3 and then another light meal. You're telling them to eat 1,200 calories, guys, what you're doing.
Yeah. You know, is this the one where he was like, well, you must have not have been doing it right?
Yes.
Ugh.
I went on a huge fucking rant about that guy on my Instagram.
Yeah.
Blaming the victim. We said, well, I didn't lose weight following your suggestions. You just didn't fast right. How the fuck do you not fast right, guy?
Oh,
tell me. Maybe if you talked to people about
what a way to talk to somebody.
You have food. He acts like calories don't exist. Like, you can get fat doing intermittent fasting. I'm sorry, but you can.
Yeah.
Calories exist.
Because you skip breakfast doesn't mean shit.
Right. And I've done it, you know, I think we talked about this in our first episode.
Yeah.
I've done intermittent fasting. It's been 10 years or so. I did it for a couple of years off and on, as I was learning and experimenting and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
And at that time I was trying to power lift and get stronger. So I was trying to bulk up, very fucking hard for me to do in an 8-hour window.
Right.
But I did it and I gained fat and I, you know, gained some lean muscle mass too. Not that much. I actually gained primarily fat. Also, I was kind of eating like an asshole, but, you know, because I was doing that whole, oh, I can eat what the fuck ever I want in 8 hours.
No,
you know?
Yeah. Fuck.
Boy, I got blocked by that guy, of course.
Did you?
Yeah.
I'm surprised I haven't gotten blocked yet from any of these people. I mean, I know
whatever
his name is.
What's that?
I'm gonna just call him out right now because it doesn't matter. Coach Tyler Protein. I'm surprised he tries to egg me on.
He does. He comes after you specifically.
He'll
call you out in his videos, like the crazy lady with the fruity pebbles creamer
fruity
or
pebbles
something.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then
Andy does healthy. Finally started interacting with him, and I love to see. She's fucking great. I love her.
Oh, she's amazing. I love her. Yeah. She really is.
Yeah, I saw that video, and I think you and I talked about that one. But all he's doing. He's trying to elicit a response because he's trying to build his following back up because that dumbass got banned, you know? So
I didn't respond to that video, but then I had to respond to the Premier Protein video because I was like, fuck this, man. I'm so sick of that. Like, he's always like, if you want to lose the fats, then you need to fucking, this is,
And then he lose the fats. Lose the fats. Lose the weights.
Right. He was promoting his freaking protein in the end after that the Premier Protein thing.
Yep. For sure.
Yeah.
And literally no qualifications there. You know, probably a decent personal trainer in person, I'm sure. But like, leave the nutrition to the actual experts or professionals, you know?
Right.
Stop fear mongering.
That's another thing, the fear mongering. Like when you see people that are putting the fear in you, like that, who's that one guy that was like, Cinnamon Toast Crunch will kill you.
I'm not sure if I saw that one.
His videos always have that do-do-do-do-do-do-do. He's like running through the supermarket.
Oh god,
the Coca-Cola,
the one that looks like he's always coked out because his eyes are literally he looks like he's on drugs.
Yeah, he's in the cereal aisle today, and then the Coca-Cola is like, these foods will kill you, you will die.
Yeah, this chemical, aspartame or whatever the fuck chemical, like I can't pronounce this chemical, therefore it's bad.
Yeah.
Where like, and then, which is funny because I saw everything's chemicals, right? Everything is chemicals. So saying food as chemicals is fucking stupid. That just shows, like, unfortunately, general, like, a lot, that's not common knowledge, you know. It's very easy to manipulate that. So it's very easy to gain a huge following by being so decisive and polarizing when it comes to that type of stuff.
Yeah. I mean, there's like arsenic and apples. I think there's formaldehyde and tomato juice. I mean, there's all kinds of shit. People just don't get, like, everything has chemicals.
Right. Yeah. 100%. It's like telling people to stay away from processed foods, you know? It's like everything is processed. I think we talked about that. Did we talk about that last time?
I don't remember.
We need a producer. Tom, what did we talk about last time?
I need to have a board in here and be like, okay, what did we talk about last time?
Yeah.
We're going fucking tangents.
And then we need them to keep us focused too. Like, no, all right, bring it back around. Like,
rein it in.
Yep.
Head south.
Did you find your clown nose?
No, actually I didn't. It was back here with my other props, but I haven't seen you use that yet. Have you used it?
I used it in the one video that I do edit, the intermittent fasting guy. I need to start using it more, but I'm happy with this thing. I'll start using it more. So
I need to find some more props. I don't want to do the flag. Adam's already got the flag.
Yeah, down. That's the red flag. That's his thing.
Yeah.
You know,
maybe
everybody does little skits, right? So I've got my keto Ken, my wig here, you know, so.
I got a, where the fuck is she?
What is it?
I don't even know who the fuck she is, but she's like some Sandra or someone, you know.
You gotta give her name. There you go. Sandra. So how could you show sugar Sandra? She hates sugar.
Awesome. Keto, that's keto Karen.
Keto Karen. Yeah, there's gotta be a Karen to the Ken, of course.
Oh my god. I don't think I have any other props. I need like a siren or something.
Yeah, there you go. There you go. Tornado siren or something. Yeah. I think TikTok's probably got those sound effects.
They must, huh?
Probably. You can find anything on TikTok, I think.
That's true.
So, yeah.
I don't look hard enough.
Yeah. You'll get sucked into a wormhole, probably.
It is. Yeah. For sure.
Oh boy. So what's been going on in your world with TikTok lately? I think you were taking some time off.
I did. I took like a 6-day break from TikTok.
How'd that feel?
Felt really good.
Yeah.
Felt really, really good. I think I posted the video of me from hiking. And then I put like an old video in my drafts, and I didn't create anything new. I didn't do any lives. But it was the first time I actually took a break in probably a year.
You need it.
Like a real break. Yeah.
Yeah. A real break from TikTok, you mean, from social media or just TikTok? Because I feel like you still haven't had a real break.
Yeah, I took a real break from like Instagram and TikTok.
Okay, gotcha.
But not from like working or, you know,
that's
still there.
Right. Yeah. For sure. I get that. Ultimately, like I want to be able to travel and run my business and do my business, and you know, and so I'm definitely putting that to the test currently, you know. Working out the bugs, working out the kinks, trying to find out what works best for me. And I want to make sure that I'm giving my clients what they need, you know, while also being able to grow the business too, right? With bringing on new coaches, which, you know, I just hired my new coach, John. I know you hired Tyler, what's his name?
Justin.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah.
So lots of exciting things there as well.
Yeah.
That presents a whole new set of challenges, right? Now we have another coach to provide for, but you know, they're putting their trust in us to get them clients and to help them grow and grow with us, you know, because I, as I grow, I want the people around me to grow, you know?
Yeah. Totally. And I think it's important to like let people know that the people that we hire are basically, they have our same values, and we wouldn't have them on our team if we didn't believe like that they believe the same things that we do.
They are an extension of ourselves.
Yes.
100%. Yeah. We want to just hire anybody to come work with us. You know,
yeah.
I'm sure you spent like, I think you knew Justin in person, right? Personally?
Yeah. We used to coach together in the gym that we worked at. And, he's an amazing coach. People love him. He, you know, we got along really well. And he was like the first person I thought of.
That's awesome.
And it's a hard position. It's like, who, you know, it wasn't easy. And like, I don't really know anybody that I'd want on my team like that, except, you know, I thought of him and he was pretty much the only one.
Yeah.
And at this point,
making that transition from in-person coaching online, that is, I don't think people realize that's very difficult, how hard that can be. That's an entirely different ball game.
Yeah.
Because then you really need communication skills. You need people skills. You need those hard and soft skills, you know?
Yeah.
You can't teach some things.
I think it's also good to have in-person experience before you go online.
100%. Sure. I agree. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because you need to know basic movements, how to troubleshoot issues, you know,
how to relate to people.
You need to know how to write a fucking program. You can't just be copy pasting. Some people do, but you can't just be copying YouTube workouts or bodybuilding workouts and things like that. And signing them to clients, you know? I can't say you can't, because there are coaches that do that.
Right.
But you know, that whatever.
It's an easier transition if you were in coaching. First.
Yeah. If you've been writing programs for yourself, for friends, family, clients, it goes a long way, you know.
Yeah.
Even just doing it for yourself, doing your own programming isn't like programming for somebody else is a completely different ballgame, right?
Yeah. I'd rather have someone else do my programming.
Yeah. I don't do my own programming on my own, you know.
Yeah. Fuck that.
I have a strength coach. He does weekly programming for me every week. I get a new workout for the week, you know,
yeah.
A new program, and I love it. That's one less thing I need to worry about personally, you know?
Yeah. Same. Yeah. My assistant is my coach, who is also my old boss.
Right. I love that. And I love that. The new coach that I hired, his name's John. I didn't know him personally, but he's from my area actually. Mm-hmm. So Kristen, the other coach on my team, she's a registered dietitian. She actually knew him personally. So he came highly recommended from her. I was like,
nice.
It's pretty much a no brainer at that point, you know?
Yeah.
Cause I trust her greatly. I really respect her, of course. And so to get that recommendation and referral like that, it was a no brainer.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Like you said, they're an extension of ourselves. They're our team. And we're here to help people, you know, at the end of the day.
It's a sign of growth.
Yeah.
Growing is good. Here. Yeah. It's scary.
It is. Growth is very scary, whether it's with your business, personally, emotionally, mentally. Growth is fucking scary, you know, because you're doing something unknown. Your body doesn't, your mind doesn't want you to do, like, it wants to be safe. It wants to be comfortable. So it's going to do everything that it can to keep you from doing that thing, you know, from taking that leap of faith, from being like, fear is, that's exactly what fear is designed to do.
Yeah.
To keep you fucking safe, to keep you grounded.
What
you gotta say?
How long?
Fear and do the thing.
What is it? What is the thing for fear? It's like a false evidence appearing real.
Yeah, I love that. Yeah, that's great. Yep.
It's like, I needed a new coach like 2 months ago, but it also took me like 2 months to be like, okay, you're right. I need it. Like Hunter was like, what do you think about, I think it's your time. I'm like, no, I'm okay. And he's like, well, I don't know. You better start thinking about it. And it's like, I got busier and more stressed. He's like, well.
Yeah. Okay. Oh my God. We literally are the same person, Beth. Our trajectories, everything that we do is like the exact same. I got caught with my pants down. I wasn't ready to, you know, so turned away a lot of clients, you know, if they still want to work with us, like hopefully that they still do, you know, but waiting lists are a thing. So,
yeah, it's so true. So true. It's like, we can't do it all alone anymore and it's okay.
Yeah.
That's what we want.
And like what I say is like, I'm literally surrounding myself with people that are smarter than me. Mm-hmm. You know, Kristen, she's a registered dietitian. Clearly I am not. Jess is a behavior nutritionist. She focuses on like cognitive behavioral therapy. And then, John is like, he's a master trainer. You know, he's been training people for over 8 years, head trainer at like Orange Theory Fitness, which is really cool to have that kind of perspective. So I I'm here to put all the pieces together, put the people in the right place and lead people and motivate people and encourage people. And that's how I do things, you know?
So. Yeah. Yeah.
Amazing. Like I'll be the first to, I'm not typically the smartest person in the room when it comes to a lot of stuff, you know, I know a little about a lot. So
That's how I feel myself too. That's why you have to surround yourself with people that are smarter than you. Like I got like Hunter that owns a gym that's owned, you know, has done all kinds of stuff that I have no clue about. And then you got Justin who's like got, you know, I think he's like certified in Olympic weightlifting and he works with like a TBI survivor and works with a lot of people with a disability. So he's got like that on him.
Very cool. That's a very unique, very unique skill set.
Yeah, for sure.
Awesome. I love that. So yeah. Well, best of luck to you and to your team. That's amazing. Yay. I'm super excited for you.
Too.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah.
We, I'm trying to think, so I'm starting to do like, now that the team is growing, I'm going to start doing like a group call every month with all of our clients as well. So, yes, I'll still do one-on-one coaching, but like I said earlier, I have no capacity. I don't think you do either. So a way that people can still get some time with me then and get that interaction with me is by doing the group calls, you know?
That's a great idea.
So I think I'm really excited to roll that out. I'm going to roll that out when I get back from this Alaska trip.
Nice.
Which is also great then too, because since we're building teams and we have teams, like next week when I'm out, for instance, my other coaches, they were more than happy. Like, they're like, what do you need from me? Like, how can I help? You know? Mm-hmm. So they're stepping up and they're hosting some calls, like they're hosting group calls and things like that themselves next week while I'm out, you know? It made me super happy and super, super proud of them and the team that we're building, but we're all here to help our clients and, you know, our team. So.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. Justin's going to start doing more lives with me until, you know, we talked today, like, you know, it's important for people to get to know him.
Yeah.
Like you were saying, you know, so he's just not this like, oh, you're going to be working with Justin. It's like, who's Justin?
Who the fuck is Justin?
Fucking Justin, man.
Right. Yeah.
Actually, I signed on someone to this afternoon before we spoke. She follows me on Instagram. And actually, when I announced Justin, she's like, oh, I know Justin. I follow him too.
No way.
Because I was like, okay, perfect. So that right there just shows that people are paying attention. Yeah. You know, so it is important to like get the other coaches now involved.
Yes, 100%. Yeah.
Yeah.
Love that. Well, congratulations.
Yes. Thank you.
Feels good, right? Get that first one out of the way. I remember when I hired my first coach to work with me, I was so fucking nervous. Like, clearly I can do this on my own for myself.
Right.
Can I do it for like, they're taking that huge leap in me or that huge leap of faith in me.
Yeah.
Will they be rewarded? You know, like, and then comes to find out, thankfully, I don't want to jinx myself, but it worked out quite well with her. And then hopefully it does with John as well. So
good. Yeah. Yeah. Cause you know, they're looking to us to help them, you know?
Yeah. Especially cause on the, like we talked about earlier, like with the online coaching realm is so, it's tough to break into, right? And especially if you don't know what if you're new to the online coaching, you don't have systems, you don't, especially if you don't have a big following either. Like there is strength in numbers. You don't need you don't need a big following to be able to acquire clients online, but it fucking helps. You know, and building systems and making your systems efficient. And so they help your clients and they make your life easier. That type of stuff is difficult.
Yeah, it really is. And that's what Justin was actually saying, because he's like, you know, the hardest part is building your systems.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, he was going to do his own one-on-one coaching. And he's like, you know, he's got a lot going on with his wife is disabled and he takes care of her a lot. And he's like, I think I'm just going to focus on, you know, coaching for you because I don't have to worry about it. And I can be there for her if something happens.
Right. So, that's awesome. Yeah. And I would never like, you know, I my coaches, like, of course they were coaching clients online. I'm like, bring your clients over. I don't care. Like, you know, we're all, you know, bring your existing clients over. And I don't care. Like, if you still want to focus on, try to get your business going too, like, whatever, I'm flexible.
Exactly. You know,
we're here to help each other. So.
Yeah, that's what I agree. Yeah. It's not like we're here to like, be like, no, you can't have that person.
Right. We're not dictators. You cannot,
And that's what I love about the Hunter that I worked for. He was so, just wanting me to succeed, and you know, whether it was with him or without,
you got a good one.
Yeah, good, and that's what you need. You know, is we're all here to help each other out. You know, it's not, there's plenty for everybody.
Yeah,
we're here to help people. We're not here to like be like now. You know.
So. Yeah, and I love that too. Like, obviously, in the in the social media realm with TikTok and Instagram, there's like the band of coaches, right? The evidence-based coaches, the no bullshit coaches, and we kind of all stick together and help each other out, unless they start turning on each other. I mean, everybody's there to bounce ideas off of each other. Maybe you've come across a problem. I know you and I do that all the time. Like, you've come across a problem that maybe I haven't before, or vice versa. Help each other out, and
You know what I was thinking the other day is what would be fucking amazing is if we can get a bunch of the TikTok coaches to like meet somewhere, like have like a meet and greet, like wherever, maybe Austin, Texas or something where,
I love Austin.
Right. Wouldn't that be like, have like Beefcake Brina, like Adam, you know, like Jeff, all these people that we've met and we've built like a community.
Right.
I feel like we should get to, I've seen some of the creators on
an expo.
That's like something where we get together and just
Fitspo Expo.
We meet each other, you know.
That's, I love that. You guys heard it here first. Beth's gonna organize it.
Okay, let's fucking do it. I think that would be fun, like a great idea.
Yeah, no, I love that actually. I think that would be really cool. Obviously,
once
we
Rona shit calms down.
Exactly. Yeah, once it's safe to do so, of course. Once the variant hopefully gets under control, but I love that.
I think we should plan that. So like, take note.
Well, now that we're putting it out there, everybody, we need you to remind us and don't let us forget this idea. Yeah. Because I think that's really cool. And you guys give us feedback too, right? Like, we want to hear your guys' feedback, what you guys think about that too.
Yeah. Like the dietitians, we can get them at like Elaine, we can get Andy, you know, all of us. Gosh,
that would be such,
wouldn't
so
it be cool. Fucking fun?
That would be so cool. So fun.
Yeah. Okay. Let's do it. And I don't know what it's going to look like, but
it's a blank canvas. We can make it whatever the hell we want.
Totally.
Yep. Awesome. I love that. That's a great idea. See, this is why we're doing this.
Yes.
All those awesome ideas. I love it.
I'm glad I remembered it, because I was thinking about it. And I was like, you know, I think we really should get together, because we tag each other. We get tagged in the same thing, like Zach Cohen, all of us together. Yeah. We need to all meet, because we all think the same. We, you know, and I think that would be a fun thing to do.
100%. We'll start with a list of people. Like, it would be cool to talk to these guys that haven't, have them come do it. And then,
pretty cool.
And Zach, I love, Zach is great too. He's been really hitting a stride lately. I've been watching a lot of his videos. He's fucking crushing it with like his meal prep videos.
Oh, like, Sunday meal prep.
Yeah. Love it. Amazing. I'm not even going to fuck around with those videos, because that's his stuff now, you know? So I've never done that. That's never been my thing anyway. You know, I don't like
spending a lot of time making videos.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, I know how much work he's putting into that, because I've done some meal prep videos, and it's like, people are like, can you do another one? I'm like, do you know how much fucking time it takes to do these things?
Yeah. 100%. And I think he's starting, I think he wants to do that full time actually is what his goal.
That's great.
And he made a video about that, which I fully support that. That's amazing if he can make that work. And I think he's getting a lot of support from the community on that too.
Good.
Yeah. Lots of good stuff there. And my meal prep, nobody would like it. Like I've done like what I eat in a day videos in the past and things like that. And I always say, like, my food will never be pretty, but it will always be tasty, you know? Fucking presentation is not my thing. I think, didn't you say you went to culinary school?
I wanted to. I wanted to. Yeah, I didn't. But the what I eat a day, and people rip you apart. They're like, how do you eat 2,100 calories? I can't believe you're having pizza. I mean, that doesn't look like, that's way more than that. And it's like, holy shit, you guys, you wanted what I eat in a fucking day. This is it.
Right. So there's one thing on the one, what I eat in a day videos that I won't do. And I don't do like my calorie breakdown or macro breakdown on my videos. Yeah. Because I feel like people are trying to like eat what I'm eating then, essentially, you know? No, I want take ideas. Like, look, you can have Doritos or pizza and still be healthy. That's what I'm trying to, the message I'm trying to portray, you know?
Yeah.
And of course, like I can lose fat eating 2,900 calories too, you know? So
yeah, that's what I'm trying to do. Yeah. They were like, I don't understand why you can eat that much. I'm like, because I've been strength training for like 4 years.
Yeah. That's a great point. You know, people are like, you can eat how much? How do I eat more calories? Well, first of all, you start by eating more calories.
Yeah. That's what I made a video about that today about your metabolism. It's like, I get 4 reasons why your metabolism sucks.
Yeah. So let's talk about that a little bit then too.
Like, you're not, you have zero muscle mass.
Right.
You're not moving your body. You're like sitting. You're not parking like farther away from the grocery store. You're actually getting the front row fucking parking.
Yeah. So if we lose weight, right? Like if you just focus on losing weight, you know, without doing any strength training and things like that, you're going to lose your muscle mass. If you even have any, you're going to get that skinny fat look, right? Mm-hmm. And you're not going to have any definition and your metabolism is going to be through the floor because of that.
Yeah.
Which is why we always talk about strength training and building lean muscle mass. We're not telling people to strength train because we want them to be meatheads, right?
Right. Exactly. And it's like a lot of people are really like focused. They want to eat as less calories. It's like, that's you're ruining right there. It's like your metabolism is going to go right to 1200. And no wonder why you're not losing anymore is because you can't unless you go to 800. And who can do that?
Right. Most people can't, not long-term at least.
No.
And we need to stop thinking about weight loss or health in general, just about what can I take away or how little can I do, right? What can I add into my diet? What can I add into my life? So most people can probably benefit from adding in more walks, right? Mm-hmm. You and I fucking big advocates for walking, add more walks into your diet, probably need to add more fruits and vegetables into your diet too. You know, stop taking things away. What can you add? What nourish your body? Do not restrict.
Yeah. And instead of focusing on that fucking scale number, focus on the habits that you're building that will in long term, you know, get you to where you want to be, but without the staples, you know?
Right. Yeah. Which is then also like, what was that?
It's just going to be a consistent cycle. If all you're focusing is on that scale number.
Yep.
Without focusing on, you know, your steps, your sleep, the building blocks.
The fundamentals, the foundation. Yeah. You can't build a house with a shitty foundation. It's going to crumble. Right. Imagine that, you know, and that's why like diets, right, don't work. And when I say don't work, they don't work long-term permanently, you know, because they haven't taught you fucking anything other than restriction.
Yeah.
They haven't taught you good habits. They haven't taught you how to eat in a way that works for you and being able to still reach your goals.
Right. That's like, I don't like number goals. Like if a client's like, you know, do you think I can lose 40 pounds by Christmas? It's like, you know, actually how consistent can you be by building the lifestyle that you want? And, you know, don't think about the number, think about the habits that you're building. And that's what's important.
Unfortunately, that's a very bad habit to break people of. Like, that's probably a lot of your time, right? As a coach, is getting people to stop focusing on the scale. I deal with that every day. Even if my clients, it's unfortunate. Like 1 to 2, like 1 pound a week is like people get pissed when they're only. I say only in quotation marks here.
Right.
Only losing 1 pound of fat a week. Like that's exactly like that's a healthy, sustainable weight loss. Mm-hmm. Remember, I don't care if you lose weight, if you gain it all back.
Yeah.
Like, you know, we are in this for permanent results.
Yeah. And, you know, and the scale still blows me away as a freaking coach. You know, I have clients that, have lost 7 pounds in 3 months, but lost 20 plus inches.
Yeah.
And, you know, if we just focus on that scale number,
they're going to be so upset, like so sad. Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
And 20 inches.
20 fucking inches, 7.5 pounds. You lost 7.5 pounds of fat and 20 plus, you lost 2 pant sizes. That's insane. Right. You know, like that's what we need to look at.
Which again, the what could be happening there and what's most likely happening there is your clients are strength training, right?
Mm-hmm.
Which then is going to manipulate that scale even more.
Yeah.
You can make weight loss very easy by just severely restricting your calories and fucking doing cardio, but you're gonna, your results are going to be shit. And I'm sorry to say this, but you're probably not going to look great if that's what your goal is either.
Yeah. So. You'll have that, what, skinny fat look, like you'll lose the weight, but then you're going to look at yourself and be like, I feel like nothing happened.
Right. Yep. I have some clients that don't even weigh in at all. You know, I take that a case by case basis with everybody.
Yeah, me too.
I would prefer that we weigh in every day. That's not ideal for most people, right? Because as we know, like, you know, or for people listening, the scale weight, we collect it to collect it as data, right? We don't collect it to determine, oh my God, yesterday was a really great day because my weight went down today, or it was a bad day because even though I ate great yesterday, my scale weight went up today. So I fucked up, you know. That's not why we collect these for data points, so we can graph it out over time, so we can see trends. Like, for instance, you know, say you're a woman, and 1 week of the month, for some reason, some weird reason, your weight goes up every time, this same time of the month, right?
Yeah.
Clearly, obviously, it's your time of the month, you're on your period. So that's going to cause that to happen. But without that, or maybe it's we see some kind of a trend on certain days of the week, right? Like maybe we're like, what's going on Tuesday or Monday that is making Wednesdays completely crazy with your weigh-ins, right?
Yeah.
Because I've had that happen before in the past. And as it turns out, this client of ours used to do Weight Watchers, and one of the days of the week was her cheat day for Weight Watchers. And she still hadn't broken herself of that mentality that had been drilled into her from Weight Watchers. So it turns out she was actually having an untracked day one day of the week, which was then causing that the scale weight fluctuation on that one day.
Interesting.
Yeah. So it's like, the more data we have, the better. We can collect it, we analyze it, and then we can improve it.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I tell my clients. I'm like, I don't look at just the scale. I'm like, I look at everything. I look at your photos, your measurements.
The scale is almost the last thing I look at.
It really is. I'm like, to be honest, I don't really focus on the scale. I focus on your pictures and your measurements way more than that fucking scale. Yep.
In any order, any order of importance for you? Obviously, you'll probably see the measurements probably change quicker.
Measurements than quicker and than photos. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Measurements, pictures, and in that order. I've had some really cool breakthroughs the last week. I had one client come up on her 6 month mark with me. Uh-huh. I sent her a picture, and she's lost like, I think, 8 pounds in the 6 months, which somebody's listening, like, only 8 pounds in 6 months. What the fuck?
Right.
Well, I did a starting picture and a 6 month later picture, and oh my God, like, midsection is so much tighter, you know, like everything's just, she's lost a lot of inches. And she said it herself when I said that, sent that to her, I was like, holy shit, like, look at this, you know? And she's like, oh my God, I didn't realize it, you know? So it's that type of stuff. Like, that's a good Friday. That's a good way to end the week, right?
Yeah, I love that. I love that when I get those end of the month check-ins with the photos, and it's like, I love seeing the data, because it's like, it shocks me every time. It's like, Jesus, you know, that fucking scale. It really is like,
yeah.
You know,
what are some other kind of metrics that you look at with your clients in terms of like things that you're checking? For myself, as part of my check-in form, you know, we're monitoring sleep, right?
Yeah, I was going to say sleep. One. Yeah.
Sleep, hydration, things like that.
Sleep, stress. I think sleep is the next number one thing. And like, what else? I'm trying to think of what else I have on my check-ins. A lot of mindset questions, like, you know, did you run into anything, any struggles? And if you did, how did you navigate it?
Yeah.
I like to see how they're, you know, processing things that they went wrong, and how do they
problem solving?
Yeah, how do they move forward from them?
Yeah.
What else?
Because then that's a teaching opportunity, right?
Yeah.
Because we don't want our clients to be with us forever. As much as we might love our clients,
exactly.
Our job is to make them prepare them to be successful on their own. So if we see them troubleshooting or not, like if they didn't troubleshoot, okay, let's talk through it and figure out what you could have done differently, right?
Yeah. Also steps. You know, see like what they're neat, like how much they're moving besides their workouts.
Ooh, speaking of steps, I have a video that I recorded last night. I'll probably post today. I want to hear what your thoughts are on it. So I think the premise of the video is like, I said unpopular fitness truth. This might be one of my biggest pet peeves. And I said, telling people to hit 10,000 steps a day is stupid, right?
It is, yeah.
And then I go on to explain why it's stupid, because 10,000 steps a day can mean something different for everybody. For myself, I get 10,000 steps a day easily. I actually average about 12 or 13,000, I think. But for Mary or Joe, that's sedentary, sitting in an office all day or working from home, getting 2,000 steps a day, telling them to go out and get 10,000 steps a day seems fucking impossible.
Sometimes it's impossible for me to get it.
You
know, it's like, starting someone from zero to 10,000, that's a big jump. That's setting someone up for.
So the easiest win right there. Cool. You're getting 2,000 steps a day right now. Let's get 3,000 or let's get 4,000 steps a day. Now you've doubled your output right there.
Right. Exactly.
And that's a small sustainable change that we made. And you probably achieved that from 2,000 step to 3,000 step jump was probably a 10-minute walk. Right.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So
yeah.
Small
shit. I agree with you on that one. Yeah.
Awesome.
10,000 is like a fucking arbitrary number to me.
And I got to make sure I give credit too, because I think I saw the Fit Adam. I think I saw him do a video on that recently.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to make sure that I don't inadvertently plagiarize him, you know? So I'll give him a shout out for sure. But I'm glad.
It's hard not to do sometimes when you're like thinking because, you know, we all talk about the same thing.
Yeah.
And then you can make a video and be like, and then scroll. You're like, holy fuck, that guy just made a video about that too.
I've had that happen a lot, actually. I did a weight loss versus fat loss video a month or two ago, and it went kind of viral. It got like 500,000 views or something.
Uh-huh.
And, somebody tagged another creator. Never seen this creator before in my life. They're like, didn't you just do this video? And so I went to their page, sure as shit. They had recently done a video like that as well. And I commented, I replied to that. I said, yeah, it looks like they did, you know, like, I hope you're not accusing me of stealing a simple concept of weight loss versus fat loss, you know?
Right. Right.
Now, of course, everything with fat loss, fitness and health, I don't know if there's any original ideas that you can come up with out there. It's all
not when you're working with science,
your own spin. Right. Yeah. It's your own spin and your own way of doing things, you know?
Yeah,
so,
exactly. Yeah. We talk about that in the mentorship all the time. And that was actually that held me back from making content in the beginning. Because I was following a lot of coaches. I was like, oh my God, I feel like I'm repeating myself or I'm copying someone. They're like, no, you're just doing it. You're speaking in your voice.
Yeah.
That's what it's. And as long as you're not taking their content and like literally like doing it verbatim or exact video.
Yeah.
It's hard not to talk about the
imitation is the sincerest form of flattery, they say.
Yeah.
You know? Now there's a very clear line between plagiarizing, of course, you know,
right.
But for instance, most people's role model that they look up to, your own mentor, Jordan Syatt, right? Like he's like a lot of his videos and content that he used to create. I don't think he creates a lot of content like this anymore, but that was inspiration for a lot of my videos when I was first starting out, you know, and for a lot of people too.
Yeah.
Do you think he gives two fucks that people are taking his ideas and spinning them? No.
No.
I mean, maybe he does, and I just don't know. But
no, I don't think he. I'm pretty sure. And I know Gary Vee talks about it too. He's like, "Who gives a fuck?" Like,
yeah, right. Exactly.
It doesn't matter.
Because again, like we said earlier, we're all here to help each other.
Exactly.
Unless, I mean, of course, you're in it for the clout, the fame, which you're also like, whatever. So.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Beth, what do we have
with
the rest of our day? I don't know what we were planning on with this one, but I think after this, I think I'm actually done for the day. I'm going to go do some housework, I think.
I'm going to take a walk and I'm going to, oh shit, my cat almost knocked over my plant.
Bad cat.
Bad kitty. I have to mail some mugs and tumblers that some people I gave away on Instagram.
Oh, I think I saw that actually. I'm actually working on merch myself right now. So that's
cool. Yeah, it's exciting. I love doing stuff like that. So I gave away.
Get those creative juices going.
Yeah. And then,
is that what you offer right now? Do you sell them or are those just like giveaways?
I sell them, but I think I took the pages down for now and I just bought myself like a case of each so I can give them away. I'm just going to do
giveaways. I love that. Yeah. And I'll probably do that same thing, like giveaway shirts and things like that. I don't foresee like merchandise being like a hugely profitable thing, you know.
It's just a lot of work to have a store up. And sure. You know, people always, no kitty, oh my god, the kitty's gonna
ruining your day.
Holy shit. You know, I always give like, take a poll, like, all right, people are like, can you make these shirts or these, you know, I want this, so I'll do it, right? And then I'll have the store all up and you got like 20 people out of like the 200 that say they wanted to buy something after you spent all this time creating this logo. And it's like,
I've learned that the hard way with other ideas that I've had. Yeah.
I just learned that. So
yeah. My first, I do have my first design that I'm going to do for t-shirts. It's a, it's very simple and it's very clearly me. It says fuck keto. So fuck is spelled F pound sign CK and then keto, the O is spelled with a donut. So
I love that. I love that.
And then I'll probably have like my Matt Larfitt or something on the back. Awesome. I don't know what, but
Right now we're creating, it sounds like mine right now. I call my boss because he was Hunter. He's like, I just did a cookbook and it's called the best fucking cookbook. And it's like, the fucking is like
awesome.
An asterisk. So he's like, yeah, we're going to do the best fucking this. And the best fucking is always going to be like the best fucking workout program.
That's amazing. And I love that too, because it's so closely. Have you ever read like the book, The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck by Mark?
I have it, but I haven't read it.
You haven't, but you need to read it. I think that would actually help you tremendously, Beth. But,
yeah. Okay.
It's not about not giving a fuck about anything. It's about choosing your fucks carefully. You have a limited amount of fucks to give. So
choose carefully. I'm going to dive into that later. I'll dive into that later.
That's one of my favorite books. And that just kind of reminds me of that.
Awesome.
With the merch.
Right. So, yeah. And I have a logo for Eat the Fucking Fruit. I have t-shirts that are going to come out for that.
Yes. That is your thing. You close a lot of videos like that.
Yeah.
I love it. I'm looking forward to seeing that.
Yeah, me too. After I all these things.
Like, great. Not enough time in the day for all these ideas.
Oh my God, I've got so many
half baked ideas out there still. So
half baked ideas, totally. Yep. I got a Zoom call tonight too for my group coaching.
Yeah. Actually, no, I lied when I said I'm done for the day. Wednesday's my late days for calls for clients. So I start calls back up at 7:30 tonight, I think, for a couple of hours. So
You ain't done yet.
Not done yet, but I got about 4 or 5 hours free right now. So
nice. All right. We're going to do our live on Friday.
Yep. 11 a.m. Awesome. Eastern.
Before you head out on your venture.
Yep. For sure. All right, Beth. Well, this one has been great. Lots of fun. I'm glad we got to catch up.
Yeah, that was awesome. All right, Matt.
Bye.
Bye.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. That is a wrap on episode 2 of Cut the Crap with Beth and Matt. We want to hear from you. Let either one of us know on Instagram what you thought of this episode, what you think of the podcast, if there's anything that you want us to talk about in general. Talk to you soon.